I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter.
Hey everybody, back out in the motorhome. And this is the vent hood or range hood in a motorhome. It used to be a nice stainless brushed look. And it's kind of hard to tell now because the camera was just, but there you go. Like in that back corner, the stainless is rubbing off, so it is not as good as I want it to be. So what I'm going to do is I think paint it, but I'm not sure exactly what color I'm going to paint it. I have three different choices. I plan on doing a stainless steel sort of backsplash. So, and to be honest with you, if you buy paint to make things look stainless or chrome, it just never looks right. So I'm going to go with a completely different color. So I'm just trying to figure out which one. So these are my color choices so far. I've got a really light silver, which is a Rust-oleum high heat. Now to be honest with you, high heat's overkill. This stove is not going to get 2,000 degrees. If it is, we got more problems than that. Rust-oleum hammered, which is my favorite paint, I think will give it a little depth, a little color, a little texture, kind of break it up a little bit. So I'm really not sure which one. So what I'll probably do is tape this area up pretty good and then give it a little squirt of the high heat, and give it a little squirt of the hammered and see what I like. So what I think I'll do is get to taping. Got to get in to get a little tape action. Cover the areas that you don't want painted. Now everywhere in here behind the wall and everything, all that's going to be painted anyway. So actually, to be honest with you, everything in here is going to be painted with you. So or painted white. So it's kind of like, you know, I need to be careful, but I don't need to be that careful. And now's the time to do it, because before the laminate floor goes in and everything else, it's time to get stuff like that done. And to be honest, I don't want to take this thing out. I'm really trying real hard not to work too hard. So I'm going to get to taping. Okay, I taped off the area I don't want to be painted. In other words, I taped the knob, and I also taped off the little sticker on there that says vent line, because I didn't want to paint the whole thing. So I kind of come want to, you know, keep the labels and all that stuff all the same. So what I need to do now is kind of start taping up underneath, and I'll tape the side, and I have a piece of plastic I'm going to drape across all this junk. And then I'll paint on that side over there, and hopefully I can be cautious enough not to make a giant mess. I do like spray paint, and I don't know, so far I'm kind of going back and forth. I haven't really made up my mind yet. High heat or hammered, I like them both. So, I don't know, still a debate. I've been debating about this for about a week. So, I mean, if that gives you any idea how long I've been thinking about it, about a week. So, more paper, more tape. Okay, I just thought about something. If you're gonna do a project like this, one of the things you wanna do is clean your area first. So I've got the label, the little vent line label all taped off. What I'm gonna do is clean this, just in case there's any grease or anything on there, because that'll keep the paint from sticking. And what I actually have in this bottle right here is a cup of bleach and some water. You can also use vinegar and some water, because bleach and vinegar will help basically let the grease come off. In other words, it'll release the grease, if you will, to kind of bring it on down so the paint will stick a little bit better. So there you go. Just I figured I'd throw that in there as a tip. So you tape the areas you don't want painted and clean it, or you clean it and then tape the areas you don't want painted. Make sure the area is ready for paint, and then when you paint, your results will be a lot better. So depending on how you do it, you know, like the reason why I didn't clean this area first is it's actually not that good. I mean, the surface area and everything, so it's just kind of one of those things. So, but remember, clean it before you paint it and your results will be a lot better. There was a bug, a gnat. It's gonna take me longer to tape everything off than it is to actually paint it. But that's okay. It'll actually, or it would have taken me longer to take the range hood out and paint it and put it back in than to do this. So right now for me, it's more efficient to do it this way. Spend a little time taping things up and then paint. Here's kind of a tip for the ladies. I got this brown paper, this whole roll of brown paper, from Harbor Freight Tools for about $3. If you go buy something like this at Michael's, it's like 10 bucks. So it's just thin, you know, craft paper. So if you're looking for something like that, you might not want to rule out Harbor Freight, especially considering they give you a 20% off coupon. Because, yeah, I seen the same thing at Michael's for like 10 bucks. I'm like, you got to be kidding me, man. We'll go to Harbor Freight and get that for $3. So there you go. That's a little tip for you. Back to taping and doing some paper and stuff. So getting there. Almost done. Another piece of paper over there and then some plastic and it should be good to go. Be ready. Okay, well, I got the plastic on it. I'm going to do a little tuck. Tuck it all in. It covers everything. And I'll tape that little wall piece off there. Use the plastic for that and I should be ready. Start painting. It's getting kind of dark. I think the sun's just passed behind a cloud. Be glad when spring gets here. Okay, I decided to go with the hammered because it seemed like it was actually working better. And I don't know if you guys can see that. It's not really a whole lot of light in here now, but because it's kind of hard to get in on the detail. But yeah, that's kind of what we're looking at. It does have a little texture to it, a little bit of shine. Covers really good in the coat. Yeah, I really like it. And I think it'll break up the stainless real good. See? Sweet. Very, very nice. Yeah, I tried the other paint, and to be honest with you, I just didn't like the way it looked. Something old like this with imperfections and things, I really like that sort of hammered look to it because it really kind of makes it much better. Very nice. There you go. That's how to paint the range hood in your mobile home, I guess. Or how to paint a range hood with Rust-oleum hammered paint. One of my favorite paints. I'm going to let this stuff dry for about 15 minutes and get all this paper and plastic and stuff out of here. Yep. Very, very nice. All right. Oh, yeah. If you do something like this in a closed space, make sure you have ventilation. I got windows open and everything, so. Well, I just want to show you. I pulled that little piece of tape I put off the put across the front. So, there you go. That's kind of what the range hood looks like, or vent hood, whatever you call this thing. Very nice. I left that little detail in there because I thought it would kind of make it look pretty good. I like it. Sort of all sort of goes together there. Yeah. Very, very pleased so far. Looks pretty good. Very nice. Bye-bye.
I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter.